Hey guys, I'm Nisha Homi and today I'm sharing Masala Bajra Roti recipe. Bajra or pearl millet is gluten-free and is a highly nutritious millet. I'm showing a trick to make super thin and perfectly round bajra rotis. Even a beginner in cooking or a bachelor can easily make this roti. And with my tips, you can roll out bajra roti just the way you roll out whole wheat atta rotis. So let's quickly get started with the recipe. To make masala bajra roti, into a saucepan I'm adding in 1 cup of water. Turn on the flame. Allow the water to come to a boil. While the water is coming to a boil, I'm measuring 1 cup of bajra atta into the same cup in which I measured the water. So that is 1 cup of bajra atta. Bajra is also known as pearl millet. Add in pink Himalayan salt as needed. And once the water starts to boil, reduce the flame to the lowest. And then add in 1 cup of bajra atta. Do not stir the atta. Cover and keep it like this for about a minute. And after about a minute, open the lid, turn off the flame. And with a wooden spoon, mix this really well. Once mixed, allow it to cool down. Bajra or pearl millet consists of complex carbs which helps in weight loss and weight management. It is gluten-free. It is a rich source of insoluble fiber which works as a prebiotic in our gut, which also helps in maintaining gut health. It's a good source of magnesium, omega-3 fats, iron and phosphorus. Those with iron deficiency anemia should try to include bajra in their diet. Recent studies have shown that bajra has anti-cancer properties and inhibit tumor development. So do try to include bajra in your diet, especially when they are in season. Once lightly cooled, transfer the bajra into the work surface. Into this, add in 1/2 teaspoon turmeric powder, 1/2 teaspoon Kashmiri chili powder, 1/2 teaspoon freshly ground black pepper powder, 1/4 teaspoon amchur powder, also known as dry mango powder. And while it is still warm, with wet fingers, mix and knead it into a soft dough. And once it has cooled down, knead it really well. And now the dough is ready. It is a smooth and soft dough. Allow the dough to rest for about 5 minutes. To roll it into thin bajra roti, pinch off a lemon sized dough and again knead that dough a couple of times. This will help to roll out into an even round and thin roti. So before making each roti, you need to make sure that you roll this small dough portion a couple of times. Dust some bajra flour on top and coat the dough with the bajra flour. Lightly flatten it out and roll it out into a round roti. See how easy it is to roll out this bajra roti, and you can see that I have rolled it into a thin roti. The sides have come out really beautiful. You can see that it is not very thick. It is just like a medium whole wheat atta roti. Dust off excess flour and place the masala bajra roti onto the hot tawa. After 30 to 40 seconds, flip it over. Another 30 to 40 seconds later, flip it over again. And once the roti is cooked, it will start to puff up. Flip it over again. So there is no need to put the roti over the gas flame. I personally don't prefer to cook roti over the gas flame. Roti will get cooked on the tawa and get puffed up once it is cooked really well. As you can see that the roti has puffed up, and I'm just lightly pressing it down with a cotton cloth. Drizzle in a little bit of desi ghee. This will really help with the assimilation of fat-soluble vitamins and micronutrients in bajra. Repeat the same thing with the rest of the dough. Remember, this small trick of kneading each dough before rolling out is the trick to get a round, thin and even shaped bajra roti. So do not skip this. Even a beginner can easily make bajra roti with this small trick. See how perfectly the roti is being rolled out. Dust off excess flour and place on the hot tawa. With this measurement, I got 6 masala bajra roti. Let me just show you how soft this bajra roti is. You can enjoy this bajra roti with dal curry or any side dish of your choice. So guys, do try this healthy masala bajra roti and let me know how it turned out. Thank you for watching, and until next time, take care. Bye-bye.